Welcome back, folks. Whew. Another little minor panic there. Looks like we've got three aircraft lined up ready to go out, which sort of like caught us off guard a little bit. Three jets ready to go for the afternoon session. Hope you're all doing well. Had a good lunch. Live now on Big Jet TV. Before I before we get really into it, just want a big shout out to didn't realise who it was actually, and forgive me for not knowing, but Stuart. He'll probably be riding his bicycle right now. I don't want to put him off, but Stuart from Airshow World. He was live from the other side of the airfield a little bit earlier on. Stuart, an absolute pleasure to meet you, sir, and wish you very well. And anything that we can do, obviously, to help you on with your shows, be more than happy to help out. Hello, what's this going on here? But great to meet you, mate. He's got a proper mobile system. Talk about mobile DJ, which actually he was a DJ at one point. He's done his stuff in the past. He's got everything on his bicycle. I want to ride my bicycle. Want to ride my bike. And stream. I want to ride my bicycle. To ride it here and now. And stream. Okay, so we do have flashing lights here. Do we have something? Is this just an exercise or? It's the big old lump, always followed by the little fella, isn't it? So, slightly different position, folks, than we were earlier on this morning. So that you know, there is a burger van here on this side of the airfield. Decent enough choice of menu. Okay, is that? Oh, hold on a minute. I've got something flapping around here. Yeah, I think we've got more lined up there as well, possibly. So as they always do, we will always get the aircraft lining up before they depart. Direct headwind now compared to what it was earlier on. I love that. I love that shot of sort of like, you know, modern technology with the lovely old brick building of the farmers, of the local farmer there. It's just great, isn't it, to see that sort of like, you know, that contrast. Anyway, welcome. Good afternoon, everybody. Hope you're well. Let's just have a little look and see what we got. Got a new member, Mike Nocta. Welcome, Mike. Hope you're well. Stephen Owens, Edward Jones, Robert Mendez. So, a little bit sort of like, I wouldn't say conflicting information coming to us now, folks, in terms of maybe I didn't get the full SP in terms of the operations this week. They are night operations. Now, somebody is going to say, well, I did tell you that someone is definitely going to tell me that, because and I think Jilly's one of those who's probably going to remind me, but I obviously was trying to deal with a few conversations at once, but apparently it's all night operations, so it is a sort of like throw the cards up in the air and see what lands. Old Barn TV, Adam Truella. We're at Lakenheath, Keith. For the afternoon session with the F-15s, more F-15s moving into position there. So we've got a four pack coming out by the looks of it. In fact, maybe even more. You can just about see them moving behind that old barn there. As soon as they start to move in position, we'll catch them going out, which they're doing right now, I think. Here comes the first one now. Okay, so this is going to be pretty rapid, folks. Get ready for this. If you've got your TV on or your headphones, crank it up to the max, but please mind your ears, because it's going to be loud. Here they go. First wave. To shoot, just because of the fact they come out so quick. Here comes another wave now. Looks like I think this might be just a single one going out on its own, so that's good. No, I think it's going to be Coningsby. I think it's going to be Coningsby, mate. Okay, here we go. short but sweet. You love it. But yeah, caught out a little bit there, I have to be honest. Could have been better. 6 out of 10 I'll give myself there. Just a little bit rusty on that one. Say a bit, dear. But that's your lot for the moment, until they come back, of course. So it looks to me like it's good. But mind you, you know, night ops, isn't it worth at least trying it? Because, well, I mean, but the only obvious issue would be, it would be much better if they were operational from this end, if the runway was switched, because then you'd see them light up from this end, wouldn't you? Because the problem that we have is just actual physical visibility with the camera. Kate Bryslin, car alarms going off. Craig B remembers when the F-15 took over from the F-111. Lots of people reminiscing about the F-111s during my lunch break here. People talking, coming up to me. Lovely couple that are here below me here who live local. Chris Webb, thank you, sir. Thank you. Don't know. I wasn't too happy with it. Camera was popping in and out as well, you know. JC, I think it's just, it's not a case of like they may, you know, Mildenhall and Lakenheath, like there were so many satellite stations back in the war. Some of the local, which you would imagine why they wouldn't build one big airfield, but there were a number of satellite airfields, and of course, you know, alternate landing grounds, as they were sometimes called, you know. So, you know, if one airbase was taken out, then obviously there'd be another one as an alternative. James Greer, thank you very much indeed. JP, thank you. Horseman, two Mustangs stranded here in the UK. Obviously, a COVID issue. There goes that Herc once again, I think, going out of Mildenhall on exercise. Is that Herc? Been quite busy down there since we came back, which is typical. You're sort of chasing your tail a lot of the time. It's a bit... Oh, go on then, mate. Yeah, please, thanks. From little Jet TV over there. Donnie Spotters. The Donnie Spotting crew making an appearance. Going to do some stuff with them. Just because they got inroads to the cruise up there as well. Picture looks pretty sharp, GP, doesn't it? C-130 Hercules, of course, yeah. Wow, you can hear it, man. Easy. Oh, nice one, fella. Thank you, my friend. More coffee. And it's hot and all, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, God blimey, he's got another Twix. Another liquid Twix.
Look up.
Can I get a straw with that Twix?
I've got a spoon.
Cheers, mate. Cool, that's a nice hot coffee as well. It's just what I need in these unbelievable temperatures. Fantastic, thank you, my friend. Daniel Hill. Not a great deal, Daniel. Not a lot. Keith Cornell. Alan B. Hello, mate. How are you? Good, good. You know what? I will have. Just let me eat this unbelievably difficult to eat Twix thing, whatever it is. Whatever it was once is not anymore. Oh, Steve,
Your brother's here getting a sticker for you. If you understand. Yeah, every word, mate. You can tell him.
Oh, bless him, he's come all the way for the Saudis and all the way from Great Yarmouth. It's a fair old slap, isn't it? So, normal procedure here, folks, if you're sort of not familiar with the layout and what normally happens here. These guys go out in waves for exercise, for training, conversion, whatever it might be, as we saw there, four aircraft wave, and then a dual going out again. Not sure what it might be. Some of these Cameron, brand new first class Chuck Cameron. Oh, there we are. What about me? I'm a brand new first class man. So shiny. Look, he's only got one stripe. There we go. Chuck, you are more than welcome. Mark Davies, 60 miles. Wow, so it's an hour, basically, for him to drive. Karen Corcoran. Key corner. Daniel Hill, now I've tuned in, everything will kick off. US Air Forces were waiting for me. Isn't there supposed to be F-22 Raptors coming in today? Yes, Daniel. Those F-22 Raptors have actually been completely postponed for the time being. Word has it that apparently there's one of the pilots tested positive. So as a result of that, they're postponing that for the time being, which is a great shame, of course. We would have loved to have seen them involved in the exercises. And of course, as we've seen, night exercises, so we're going to have to sort of like play it by ear this week, folks. I think the only surety that we have this week at the moment is most definitely Wednesday at London Heathrow. Mike's been singing Salesman. What's been put back to the 16th? Oh, has it? Oh my God, that's one down then. Vistara's been put back to the 16th. Oh, flipping heck. So we're now down to one. ANA 777 with a member on board. Michaela Taylor. Is it Michaela Taylor? No, it's Michelle Taylor, sorry.
Should have stayed at Mildenham.
Oh, okay. F-22 Raptor, yeah, indeed. Awesome piece of kit. Looking quite a lot. The F-22 Raptor's got quite a sort of like F-35 look about it, hasn't it? Sort of like, similar sort of like design. Very sort of like compact aircraft, I think. Lynn Keeble, good afternoon. Alan Davis. Okay, VJ Day fly past this week, Reds with the Reds, and they're doing a display in the valley today. Okay, so. Okay, VJ Day is this week. Okay, fair enough. Would be. Mike. What's the deal with Marham this week? Are they nights or day ops? Oh, chicky. No, Michelle, it's fine. It's absolutely fine, sorry. Because we have Michaela's and Michelle's and Michael's and all different sort of like variants of the name, which is you know, sometimes a little bit confusing when I'm reading out the comments, but there we go. So Michelle, leave it as you are. Original Kartmeister, Mrs. Kartmeister, says that I like you live here, Jerry. Every time she goes in a room, she hears your voice. Mrs. Kartmeister, to the kitchen, please. Mrs. Kartmeister, to the kitchen. Thank you. Wow. Don't they have... they do definitely have aircon inside. The pilot can actually tune his aircon prior to departure. That's to get themselves... One of the most important things, of course, on board these aircraft is to get yourself comfortable. You can't be burning up in the flight deck. Chris Webb loved the YouTube footage earlier. Wow. Good afternoon. Ruth Cole is watching. Hello to Jerry and Jilly and everyone. Banton Radio. Banton Radio is wanting to speak to you, I think, Jilly. Michelle Taylor. Horseman Karen Corcoran. I didn't enjoy my unch. I did enjoy my lunch, though. We've gone heel and Gordon Farmer's Forge. Oh, Gordon, didn't have to do that. Thank you very much anyway. Really appreciate it. The Horseman. I have to hook up with you, Horseman, Mr. Horseman, because I would... I'm desperate to do something with a Mustang. Are they, which Merlin variant are they running on those P-51s, Mr. Horseman? Kieran Barrett is going to Lakenheath tomorrow from Surrey. Andre is a new member on Big Jet TV. How are you doing, Andre? Okay. I think we've got another problem with his email server, Chilly, because I'm getting mail delivery systems all over the place, and emails that I sent like ages ago, or ones that I possibly didn't even send. Okay, but there we go. Craig B, F-22 was built only for the US Air Force, only 187 built due to high production costs. Wow. F-22 Raptor. Again, Yeah, Daniel, yeah, very true, actually, about, I was lying about what happened earlier on, about not a lot happened on. Well, yeah, we did get some good departures earlier on. I'd be honest with you, I'd prefer to shoot this kind of stuff with a moody background sky, so I can pick the aircraft out a lot easier. In this haze, it's quite difficult, but even when they're just taking off. But, hey, we can carry on. But but yes, of course, the U2 earlier on was just an epic catch. It has to be said. Say it again, dear. So not a great deal going on here in terms of. Jeff should not be too hard. F-22 two engines. F-35 one. Okay. I think he's talking to me, not Jeff. I don't know who Jeff is, but anyway, F-22 has two engines, whereas the F-35 just a single engine. But I'm talking about the overall design, the look of the aircraft, compared the F-35 versus the F-22. They've got a similar sort of, let me just bloody Google it, for crying out loud. Let's just see where I'm talking absolute. F-22 Raptor. Okay, so there's the, it's got a, let's just see it from that angle. Not really, no, actually, the F-35 has got a more sort of like, you know, prominent wing, whereas the F-35 seems to be a lot more compacted wing. Yeah, so it is a completely different aircraft. Gosh, it's an amazing aircraft, amazing looking machine. Jeff Anderson, I've seen lots of F-22s, but I have yet to see an F-35. We've got to get up to Mara, haven't we? It's got to be a bit like a. It's got to be a bit like a. A bit like a. A bit like a Toulouse. Jackie B, thank you. Wishing all new members well. Caleb Weather Dude. Indeed, it is scorching. It is scorchy right where I am. Bash mode. Cats gave her a break. It's nice, isn't it? It's the Packard Horseman, thank you. I think the Packard was the Packard was the Rolls Royce engine that was fitted to the Canadian Lancasters as well. So the most powerful of the variants, I think. James Clark. Andre, good afternoon to you. Welcome to Big Jet TV. James Clark's come asking me, what's your favourite army plane? Oh, it's again, it's a bit like that. It's a bit like the commercial stuff, I'll be honest with you. For me, it's I love them all. I don't really have a favourite because each is unique in its own way. So, a little bit of a difficult one to answer that, of course. So, I can't think that we're going to get any more sort of like exercises going out this afternoon. Ken Woodall, good afternoon. Colin McCann, is it, asking for a shout out to his wife for their 29th wedding and anniversary with Elaine. Congratulations, guys. Big congratulations. 29 years. Wow, fair play. That's and he's saying thanks for putting up with him for all these years. But match made in heaven. That's brilliant. Congratulations, guys. Yes, Andre, we're aware that unfortunately we were expecting the the Saudi F-15s this afternoon, but they have indeed been postponed for 24 hours. Yeah, the American version of the Merlin. Okay, I thought the Packard was the Packard Merlin. Okay, so Packard Merlin. It's the, Packard is the American, the company that built the Merlin under license, I'm guessing is what you're saying. Right, okay, okay. So fair enough. Karina, good afternoon to you. Jeff Anderson, the F-22 was built just north of where I live at the Lockheed Martin plant here, just north of Atlanta. Wow, in Marietta. Wow. Oh, Gordon Farmer's Forge. You didn't need to, but thank you very much indeed. I will make sure that I get myself a cuppa on the way back. I'll put your name on the mug. Stephen Billings. Well, they, yeah, good... Good call. We obviously caught the U2 earlier on, which we were very fortunate to do. She's been moved off the runway. I'd love to know how they actually managed to move that thing. Yeah, really interesting because obviously they don't have the stabilizers unless they carry a spare set with them, which I find very unlikely because they're big, tall, heavy, cumbersome things, and that's obviously going to add a lot more weight to the aircraft as well. So they would have, I don't know what they would have done in terms of, would they have perhaps got them down from Fairford? Was that the perhaps the delay, the reason for the delay? How far is Fairford from here? Send someone up there to grab a set of stabilizers, bring them down here, bolt them to the wings, and then move her off the runway, because she's obviously a very... Yeah, she's off the runway. Yeah, the runway's operational now. But what I'm saying is that, you know, if they didn't use the stabilizers to get her off the runway, how did they get her off the runway? A couple of pieces of 4B2 with an old trolley wheel. Jeff Anderson walked an F-22, wing walked an F-22 at an air show at Dobbins before. Wow. Wing walked an F-22. At an air show, as in stood on the wing. Yeah, it must have been static, yeah. Yes, Packard Merlins, there we go. A TCC, yeah, as far as I know, they're still using the U2 for as a high altitude spy aircraft, isn't it? I think they literally run the engines right down to idle because it's got such a huge wing on it. It just acts as a glider when it's up there, and it's got that massive, I wouldn't say massive, it's just got that big radome on top of it as well. Yeah, so built by Packard under license from the Rolls-Royce blueprints, I'm guessing. Dick Dastardly missed the four F-15s again overhead North Yorkshire. Okay. Edward James, yeah, US built Packard Merlins, because Packard, I think, is an American company, or was an American company. You know, you find these things all the time. Like, for instance, the... You're right, mate? Oh, Hercules coming in. We've got Hercules coming in. Thanks, mate. Here we go. Got a little bit of action, GP. Hercules inbound. Yep. Hopefully he'll run it. Hopefully he'll run it all the way down to the end of the runway. Now, why is this, I wonder? Would they be doing that? Because that approach actually runs straight over the far left-hand side of the runway, doesn't it? Down at Mildenhall. Oh well. It's a bonus. Oh, sorry about that. Ramstein. He's come from Ramstein. Oh, wow. He's going to have to come all the way down here because there's no other exit, is there? Go left though. There's some wow, how well tuned are those engines? Synchronized, look at that. From Ramstein Air Base. Air Force Base, should I say. Yeah, he's going to come straight past. Basically going to go down the because they've got some sheds down there where they'll probably offload whatever is on there. Oh, and just as that's happening, I can hear F-15 starting up. The howl. Cool. Prattney F100. What's that, GP? Hayden Thirrell, good afternoon to you. Good afternoon, everybody watching on Facebook right now. All our esteemed supporters, thank you so much for your support, folks. Another startup. Jackie B, F-35, known as Fat Amy. Oh, I'm sure Amy's not very happy about that. Jackie B, thank you for that information, by the way. Edward James. Okay, so Noah Hart is kind of agreeing with me on the whole F-22, F-35 sort of like look about it. Definitely the way to tell the 22 versus the Eurofighter, the 35 would be the wing, definitely. Both have that incredibly stealthy look about them. Of course, the only reason why so only 180 odd, I think, of the F-22s were built was because of the cost, the unit costs. Crazy, man, crazy. Dave Edwards' Mustangs were either Allison or Merlin powered. Yeah. Okay, Colin McCann. Wow, that's I'm a long way down in those comments. You guys on YouTube, slow down. Robert Mendez, EGPX, Paul, chocks away, Paul. He's watching at work. Edward James, David Edwards, JF Bryson, C-130s. Very old now, isn't it? Certainly had their money's worth out of them. Yes, JF, I agree. I mean, obviously, you know, one of those aircraft that's still around from the old air show days. You know, you remember the old C-130s. Lovely old car just turned up. Lovely old car, man. As you probably just heard him slamming it in reverse as well. Looks like an old, it is an Alfa Romeo. First cars to win the Formula One World Championship Grand Prix at Silverstone. Curving Pepper. Good afternoon to you, Curving Pepper. Gareth Lewis, thank you very much indeed, Gareth. Blade 929, 334 million for the F-22 versus 91 for the F-35 per unit. Flipping heck, what a crazy difference that is. Can you guys, by the way, hear that whistling in the background there? I don't know if you can actually pick it up, but there's at least one F-15 starting up. I don't know where she's at, but that's the trouble with this airfield, or with any airfield really, is the noise, the sound, sort of like pings off of different buildings, so it's always a little bit difficult to figure out exactly where it is, and you're looking over one side of the airfield, and the next thing you know is he's coming out from the other side, which is always good. Jake Harvey, good afternoon to you. Lovely car, sir. Oh, thank you very much. Oh, did you? Did you see yes. Great, wasn't it? Oh, so you knew it was happening anyway. Oh, okay. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, sir. So Philip Thorley saying it's the same as the B-52 buff. I remember at RIAT 2004, get this, RIAT 2004. So we're talking 26 years ago, yeah? No, 16 years ago. 2004, yes? Sorry. Brain fade. 16 years ago, yes. 16 years ago, the commentary said by the end of their service lives, they will have been in service 100 years. Wow. Is that, are we talking about the C-130s there? Well, Jackie Green, no, I didn't know that. I know that Brad Binder won number 33, won the MotoGP, but apparently a number 33 won Moto2 as well. Brilliant. Curving Pepper, Charles Tomlinson. Thank you very much, Charles. Should we get down? Oh, here we go. Quickly nip down to Heathrow to get the A380. And then nip back to Mildenhall, see what's going on. Right, hopefully we're going to get a nice juicy... We won't get a run and brake, but we might get a nice overfly here. Yeah, some of you folks, by the way, if you've ordered merchandise, sometimes it can come separately, just because it comes from a different manufacturer. So sometimes it will come straight from the manufacturer, or it will come to me first. I'll package it up. And so this guy's on his own. Let's see what he does. Is flying over the field. Go on, son, open it up. Open the taps. The old car alarm again. Maybe it might be an idea to turn the car alarm off. Disengage your car alarm.
Blimey, look at that old thing.
Wow. That's a vehicle and a half, isn't it? Some kind of a loader. That's probably for that Herc, I'd imagine. Wow, look how many wheels he's got. Looks like a flipping Antonov undercarriage section just driving along on its own. That's nuts. It's probably going to be cool, isn't it? Oh, mate, you don't have to. Oh, you're a star, man. Go on then. Thank you, sir. Cheers. You're a legend. Let's get you by your car, sir. Let's just get you by your car. Go on, put your hand on your beloved car. There we go. Fantastic. Alfa Romeo. Beautiful. Untouched as well, by the looks of it. Okay. Here we go. And a nice can of Sprite. Cheers, sir. Thank you very much. Oh, thank you.
Where do you live?
London. Just near Heathrow, very close to Heathrow. Yeah. Yeah, you've got to do it. I've left my silly hat in the golf bag, unfortunately, so I've got to look like Lawrence of Arabia today. Here they come. Okay, get focused, son. Get focused. Where's he at? 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 What's up? Yes. Oh, great. Yes, thanks, Ben. Ben up in Marham, most definitely. Be in touch very soon. Possibly even as early as on my way back from here. Because we want to sort of see what we can do about... I mean, looks like Coningsby is definitely on the cards, but I think a lot of people are very desperate to see that F-35. So now I think when they come out, they take the remove before flight pins out. But are they just doing a visual inspection here, or are they inserting actual flight pins? To save the pilot having to do it, I guess, or all the teams having to do it when they get into the... Let's just have a little look. Because it's quite a lengthy inspection, isn't it? Pre-flight inspection before they go out. Certainly doesn't seem to be as detailed. I don't know, though. I couldn't see them carrying any flight tags. Perhaps somebody can let me know. Donald Palmer, thank you. Thank you very much indeed, Donald. Wow. If I missed your comment, folks, please come back on and re-comment. 35 in Dorking. Robert Colborne. You all right, mate? How's it going? That's us. Oh, have you? Did you watch that one down at Mildenhall?
The one this morning.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, really? That was crazy. I left here because it went quiet. The word was that there was apparently a U2 that was coming in. We didn't know the full gen on it. Just drove down there and literally got in the car park, got on top of the van. Within seconds of the unit firing up, it came into land. So we just got it. Well, yeah. I mean, they stopped. They closed the runway and obviously had to get it off the runway. But apparently, it was an engine issue. So he requested the arrestor cable. I'll get your sticker, son. Okay. I've got to say hello to Leanne and Isla from Doncaster Spotters. There we go. Leanne and Isla. Hope you're well this afternoon. Leanne and Isla. Got the Doncaster Spotters contingent here. Going to hopefully be doing some stuff with them in the near future. Got an idea, got a plan to sort of like do some shows with the nice spotting crews around the country and around the world, actually. So if you run a spotters group, then by all means give us a shout and we'll see about doing a show with you guys, because you are the folks that started this whole thing, really, you know, on Facebook before Facebook came along. What was it, just forums and stuff, wasn't it? So keen to do some stuff with the original groups. The Donny Massive. So are they carrying any... Oh, that's what it is. Phone's dying, isn't it, GP? I keep getting the boop. But you know what? I might be able to power it up remotely. Let me just check. Stand by. I got this, thanks, mate. Thank you anyway. Cheers. So that's the, it was a four pack that went out first, wasn't it? Now there's two pack back first. Which is quite interesting, but that's just the way they do it. There's no oh, no thanks, mate, I'm all full of that, thank you very much anyway. Cheers, fella. Okay. Can you hear planes? Okay, that's running nicely. That's running that fan. It's running that. So what we need. Oh, Daniel Morgan, some flights are not flying at Coningsby this week, apparently. Lionel.
What's up, mate? It'd be good if it did, wouldn't it? Don't know what she's in for. She's from Germany. She's coming from Germany, so... just one of those things, isn't it? You just never know with these guys, man. I mean, they may turn it round and just oik it out, you know. I don't think they're picking anything up, per se. It's more worth hanging around for. It's got nothing else to do, I guess. Fair play, man. We've got night exercises this week as well. So that's another thing we want to consider as well. Those reheats going out at night. Oh, are you? Wow, lucky you. You gonna get out and play a game of golf, son? Hey? Wow, cool, man. Yeah. Wow, that's really cool. Good for you. See you in a bit, yeah? Thank you.
Oh, look, that's what's coming off of that Herclet. There you go. Hey, hey. Couple of 20 foot, oh no, couple of, oh no, I don't think that has come in off that Herclet. Well, maybe it has. No, they'd be in container, they'd be on in crates, wouldn't they? They'd be crated up. I doubt very much they just, I don't know though. Or is he just shifting that from one side of the airfield to the other? No, that's definitely containerised, isn't it? The old fella. What a great, what a cool little, what a big truck that is. Yeah. Deserves a big old horn on that. Has he got... Dunno. That might have come in off that Herc, you never know, right mate? Hey! Right GP, if you can hear me, I think the phone's disabled itself. So I'm gonna go now to see, it won't even. What's that, mate? Oh yeah, no worries, man. Oh, that's cool, man. That's cool. Oh yeah. Well, I just said that we'll possibly do some stuff with spotter groups around the country, you know, or around the world, you know. Fiaz Lugman. Right, GP. Let's 20 wheels. Someone counted there. Is it 20 wheels? Hey, okay. We are back to back in business. There we go. Everything all right? Tim Franklin quickly counted 20 tyres, 20 wheels. I don't know if you can see that. Tommy Ernst in the house. G'day, Tommy. Seen you for a while, my old son. Hope you're well. Robert Mendez, yeah, he doesn't. Oh. Hello? What happened there? Oh. Oh no. Oh no. No? Why? What's up? Oh, okay. The horseman. When did you want to do a flight? Is this linked to when we were talking about it some time ago? Is that the P-51? Yeah. Well, the thing is, to be honest with you, I am a chicken. I'll be honest with you. You know what? And to be honest with you, I'd sooner sacrifice flying on that plane than actually filming it for the viewers, because I think that would just be an awesome thing if we were to come to Duxford. And not only that, but I've also been contacted by Duxford regarding some future stuff, so it might be an opportunity for me to come up there. You're only down the road from here, really, and come down there, say hello, pump fists, pump elbows, whatever it is you do, Well, yeah, but the aircraft have been they're stranded here, aren't they? I think they're stranded here. I think the horsemen and the aircraft are stranded here because they can't get back to the US. So therefore, is there a possibility that we could do? I mean, are you running the aircraft? Are you running the engines? I mean, to be honest with you, even if it's a ground run, I don't have a problem with that. That would be pretty cool. A three-ship routine. Okay. SHIP for Papa, yeah? Yes, I did get that the first one, the first instance. Three aircraft? A three-ship display? Wow. Yo Kennedy saying, love the museum at Duxford. It is a fantastic place to visit. Very much like the one at... Toulouse. It's got a fantastic outside display as well, including the VC-10, Concorde inside as well. Let's do something with you, Horseman. But have we got his details and all that, Julie? Can you send? Okay, we've got. He's got his phone number. Got his phone number and all that. Okay, Horseman, can you send all your details, including your phone number, a UK contact number, to info@bigjet.tv, and we'll set something up for sure. I'm not sure if I do keep from time to time trying to reach out to the to the folks at Duxford, but obviously their media team, I still think that they're furloughed or they're just working from home at the moment. Mike Werrett, I was playing golf yesterday when I heard a loud shout from another fairway. Come on, my son. I turned round, but it was not you. Big Duxford TV, go for it. Yeah, man, I mean, yeah. Yeah, I mean, you know, GN man saying you might regret it in the future, go for it. I mean, you know, I can't live stream from the cockpit to start with. It would just be a personal experience, which, yes, don't get me wrong, flying on a warbird like that. Is it a converted aircraft if it's a two-seater? Because obviously the P-51s, the original P-51s, were single-seater fighter aircraft. So was it a converted, like a bit like the Spitfires? But anyway, it's something that we can discuss. Let's come and do a show with you guys. A good opportunity while you're stuck here in the UK. Let's go and do a show with you guys. Most definitely. Really would love to do something with you with your team. The Horseman, yes, it's our famous display. Okay, so then let's do it. Martin Smith, indeed, Duxford is a flying museum. Got some great exhibits there. Do you know, I think the Blenheim was actually rebuilt there, if I'm right in saying it. They've got a fantastic department there which rebuilds warbirds, and I think that the Blenheim was one of those that is now part of the collection. I don't know which collection that is part of. Probably Duxford, I imagine. Awesome Horseman. Another shout out to Stuart as well, by the way. Stuart from Airshow World. Great to meet you, my friend. And check him out on YouTube, folks. Stuart from Airshow World. Edward James, I was so hoping a Duxford slot would come up one day. Great news. Well, I've been wanting to do a walk around the museum. The plan was contact all these museums, as many as we can. But I'm constant. It's a constant rotation where I'm trying to speak to all these guys and girls, just to reach out and touch somebody's hand. But the offering them the opportunity, much like what we did at Toulouse the other day, even though the museum was open and are now a lot of these... I don't know if Duxford is open yet. Is Duxford open now? Yeah, Horseman, can you send me all the details, all the info, where we check you out on YouTube? And also, if you want to post the link in here, you're more than welcome to as well. I think we can do that, can't we, Gilly? Or is it illegal to do that? Not illegal, but it's against the rules, is it? So, I don't know. Someone come round Horseman's house. Excuse me, sir. Would you mind stepping outside, please?
We have reason to believe that you've been putting all your things on the YouTube. Do you have anything to say about this? Bear in mind, anything you do say may be taken down in evidence.
Anyway, Neil Schwartz, I was going to Duxford in September, but our borders are still closed. Gutted for you, Neil. Andy T telling us Duxford is now open. Okay, let's get it on. 0 and Austin, good afternoon to you. Becca O'Dell opened last week. Fantastic. Okay, well, I therefore can go ahead and put another feeler out to my contact there, because we were just before COVID struck. We were planning a meeting, so let's get that on. Herc coming in, Dick Dastardly saying. Herc coming in. Hope I got this right. Talistic, welcome to first class, Talistic. Duxford was sensational the last time he went TCC. Horsemen, they fly as a tribute to the guys that flew them in World War II. Yeah, of course, the boys that flew the Mustangs, especially in the European theatre, predominantly were bomber escort, I think. So that they could, and they utilised the drop tank capability. And so that they could fly deep into Germany and protect the bombers, the B-17s. Are you off, boys?
No.
Oh, okay. About 20 past, yeah? Cool. So yes, and I also think that I think back when the UK, or sort of, should I say, the Allied forces reclaimed the French, kicked the Nazis out of northern France. I think some of the Allied forces, the Americans actually had some bases, one or two bases in northern France as well. But most of them, I think, were based in Norfolk. I believe. Anthony Cliff, Herc was for Mildenhall, yes, and she's just done a go-around procedure, or just a fly-past. In fact, funny enough, Neil, that's exactly who I'm talking to at Duxford. Thunderbolt Dragon. They fly out of Chino. I mean, Chino's California, isn't it? Isn't Chino California, I think? Okay, so Jason, won't it? Normally does, doesn't it? But apparently he can't. The lice 2011. Jason, got YouTube on, great streaming, sat in the garden in Reading, Berkshire, enjoying the feed. Good day to you, Jason. Red Tails were the famous P-51 squadron made up of African Americans. Yes, some great stories about them that I've read and seen. Duxford had P-51s and P-47. Thank you, Bolt. Allenby. Okay. Stephen Owers loves Duxford, just down the M11 from him. P-51 only became great once they put the Merlin engine in. Yeah, very true, Stephen. Martin. Martin Smith saying about the Merlin engine being, that it did become a real powerhouse. Once Packard got the rights to manufacture the engine out there in, it was Canada and America, wasn't it? I think Nanton. That's why the Nanton Lank is as it is, but they built the Lancaster bomber out there with the Packard Merlin engines as well. Blimey, isn't that the second time that's happened? Tim Franklin would love to be in a Lancaster bomber when it's in flight, where the front gunner would be. What an amazing experience. Well, I'll tell you what, Tim, you wouldn't really want to be crammed into that front gun turret, I can tell you, very, very little. In fact, you're dangling in the front turret because it just literally, a bit like the rear gunner, had a seat that was sort of like suspended rather than getting up into a turret like the rear gunner. But interesting. The probably the most spectacular spot would be in the bomb aimers compartment, I'd imagine, just below, obviously below, because during the war, the bomb aimer did double up as the front gunner as well. Speedy Rabbit saying, can you say hello to my wonderful partner Danny, who puts up with my love of aviation? She sat here watching this with me, trying to get her into it all. Okay, well, there we go. Well, I can understand why she's probably going like, what is going on here? The bloke's just looking at a couple of planes parked up there. But trust me, Danny, it will get better. And be patient with old Speedy Robin. We'll do a whole piece on you guys, horsemen. Sandy Humby, good afternoon to you. Leslie Eglinton. Of course, we've got those four jets that went out. Waiting for them to return. Kaneko Ishii. Is that Kaneko Ishii I see? Ken Baker, good afternoon to you, Ken, over there on Facebook. Hope you're well. Emma Funnel, Rob Hobbs, enjoying the show from sunny Surrey, having a cold one in the garden. Oh, lucky you, Rob. Sit back and enjoy. Ken Baker. Hopefully we will be able to bring you a little bit more action. Well, we are going to bring you a little bit more action this week. Things will pick up tomorrow, whether we're here at Lakenheath, whether we're going to go to Coningsby, whether we're going to head up to Marham. Most definitely, we're going to be local on Wednesday for a customer, a member, who's flying in on the ANA 777. We did promise to get that for them, so we'll get up there and do that. The Tuskegee Airmen. Wasn't that the African American guys that flew the P-51s, the Tuskegee Airmen? I'm not sure, or have I got that wrong? Reach out and touch. Wade Perry hoping that the F-15s will return in time for bedtime. Well, how long we got, Wade? Oh, Banton. Banton, if you do sell that, I'd rather you put that 25% towards a charity, if you would please, my friend. And we'll do all we can to help you sell that. Just what it is we can do to help you sell that, we will obviously do our best. But the 25%, please put that towards a charity. We would appreciate that. Trone Hunter, thank you very much indeed. Gordon Farmer's Forge again. Thanks to all the servicemen and women all over the world, I'm guessing you're talking about there, Gordon. Most definitely. We're always in awe of those folks. And the great work that they do. He's got an hour, Wade. Yes, I think we'll be all right, Wade.
I think you'll be all right, mate. We should make a...
Somebody's hanging. Oh, now, is this possibly something going on the Herc? Should be big plumes of black smoke coming out of that thing normally, isn't there? Robert Edwards, good afternoon to you. Wow. Had a passing storm in Swansea, more expected later. So I hope to see some decent lightning flashes so I can record it. Yeah, the thing to do is just to try, if you can, I'm guessing, to leave it on... Well, it's time-lapse is a difficult thing, isn't it? Because if you leave it on time-lapse, the chances are... my luck anyway, during the time that it's off is when the light will flash. But there we go. Thank you, Banton. Tim Franklin, yes, indeed. What is in the containers? Is that being loaded into the... into the C-130. Who knows? Seaplane. Yes. Interesting. You notice, obviously, that they are left-hand drives, the vehicles here on the airbase. But interestingly enough, when you drive up here in the morning, when they're all queuing up outside the base, predominantly they are all sort of like Mustangs and stuff like that, all left-hand drive. Good afternoon, Valerie Dickens. Marco is back again. Oh, this is the fuel truck going out for the Herc, I reckon. Jet fuel. Listen to that thing. So, could get that Herc going out in the next hour, one would hope. If that fuel truck continues down to the right there. Yeah. Okay. Wow.
Kev P. He's got the week off, sitting in the garden for the whole week. He's just going to sit in the garden the whole week with a cold beer, watching this. Wow. Should have been in Lanzarote, but watching this makes up for it. Oh, Kev P. That's great. That's great to hear that this makes up for it. Big Jet TV, you only catch lightning strikes when they hit an aircraft. Martin Smith, yeah. Rene Corticas, back from work with planes. Jerry and Jilly, Robert Edwards. I don't know if the original colour was red, true, Andrew. I think they just emblazoned it with red lettering just to make sure that people are aware that you don't smoke within 50 yards of the flipping thing. Good afternoon to you, Farmer Steve. Hello there. James Clark putting up some Vulcan wing, some Vulcan emojis. Views from flight. Jerry could beat the Herc to Mildenhall. Nick Collins. Next show will be tomorrow, Nick. Keep an eye out for updates on the app. Gid 14 over Stephen O's house in Mildenhall. Oh, here they are. Got a run and break going on here. Come on, come on, come on. Help me out here, help me out. Oh, I'm struggling. See a bleeding thing. Did it? Get at least one go around here, I would have thought. Yeah, just ruined my eyesight for the sake of. Okay, here we go. First one coming in now. Hot. Come on, guys. Oh man, come on, focus, you son of a.
Say it again. Do you know what I think I can hear? I think I can hear...
Are you off? Very nice to see you. Take care and keep watching and we'll... Lovely. Thank you, sir. You're an absolute star. Thank you. Lovely. Thank you. Say, yeah, make sure you come on next feed, yeah, to say hello. Ah, lovely couple. Locals. Hello. Do I do stickers? I've got stickers, yeah. You want one? Oh, bless. All right, I'll jump down in a minute. I won't be long. Thank you. Take care. Nice to see you. Oh, bless. I'll be down in a minute. All right. Actually, that doesn't sound stupid, Dan. LN is actually the squadron code for the base in the US, which is, even though you would think it was short for Lakenheath, but no, it's not. It's, is it? No, it's the US base. It's the US base where they are based. Isn't it? Is it not? It's Lakenheath, is it? Oh, okay, it is Lakenheath. Okay, you see? Oh, that was it. MU, wasn't it? MU? Mountain something. Yeah, that was it. Yeah. Yeah, that's why I'm confused. Yeah. Sorry. It is Lakenheath, LN, yes. Like, no, it's not. No, it's not. You know, flipping it, mate. Come on. It is Lakenheath. And thanks to the guys down here and everybody else saying it as well. Yeah, but you're right, Dan. It is. And no, it's not a stupid question. It is indeed Lakenheath. LN is Lakenheath. But it was Mountain, what was it? River Deep, Mountain High, the other one. Down to me. Mountain Dew.
Yeah. Here you go, love.
It was MO or MU, Sarah Deal. Good afternoon to you, Sarah. I hope you're well. Nigel Brown. I think it was MO or MU, one of the two, wasn't it? Dan Barrett is 15 miles away as the C-130 flies. I like that. Never heard that before. Ooh, cooling showers. He's 15 minutes away from Northern. So, don't know where those are. So now what we're basically waiting for is... I'm good, thanks, mate. Thank you. I think that's about it, folks. I think we're done. Edward James, MU is maintenance unit. Yeah, that's what it was in the past, wasn't it? 1656 maintenance unit, MU, was where the Halifax from Lindholm in Yorkshire flew out of. Mountain Home, that was it. MO, it was MO, Mountain Home. Thank you, Mick. Was it Nick or Mick? Nick, there we go. Mountain Home, yeah, and Andy Kitson as well. Sarah Deal, we have Hanscom Air Force Base near Boston. Good afternoon to you, Sarah. Is Sarah from Hanscom Air Force Base? Wow, great if you are. See that Herc in the wow, he's pulling some proper maneuvers. That Herc, man. So the final one. Mountain Home, Idaho. No, I think that's all the aircraft that I think so. Yeah, Kelvin Grant, he's absolutely right. It was I think it was the first show that we did with the Mountain Home squadron from Mountain Home. When do you visit Belgium airports, Danny Gloudman's asking. Well, at the moment, wouldn't be able to do any of that, would we? Wouldn't be able to visit Belgium because of the restrictions. They're on the naughty list, yeah. But even so, most definitely would love to. I'm just wondering, are we sure that that's... We went to Brussels, didn't we? See you, mate. What's that, sorry? That's it. What about the hook? It's going out, isn't it? Yeah. Yes, think so. Yeah, yeah. Nice to see you, guys. Yeah. Lastminute.com. Cheers, guys. Possibly, yes. It's like that, isn't it? Huh? Yeah, I know. All right. That makes up a very long day. It does, doesn't it? Yeah. Thanks, guys. Take care. A couple of nice lads. Just pulled up and said hello. So I think we're done, folks. I think we're done, aren't we? I think that's it. I think that's it, folks. Just make sure that those... It did seem that there were... more than four aircraft that taxied up there, but we'll see. Just give it a few more minutes, just in case. Yeah, that is definitely it. I think the gates are closing up. I think that's it. Okay, ladies and gents, well, more tomorrow. Let's see what happens tomorrow. Lawrence of Arabia. How you doing? You all right? You all right? Want a cuddle? There we go, you all right there? Here's it. So let's just bring this around here so I can get you a little bit more in the sun. There we go. Hey, there he is, look. So, yeah, day one of Afterburner week is complete. Not quite going the way we thought it would. Well, me personally, a bit of miscommunication on my part in terms of the nighttime exercises. However, let's see what happens, what transpires. We're definitely going to be back on air tomorrow, folks, and then, of course, on Wednesday, and see what happens, because 11th to the 13th is this exercise. So whether we head up to Coningsby, whether we do something at Marham, it's Ben, isn't it, that we're going to be speaking to at Marham. And of course Mike as well, want to get some F-35 action. We'll just have to see what comes along, folks, but rest assured, I don't just leave here and that's it, is it? Well, you know what, it's funny you should say that, because no, it's everyone's going, man. I mean, even the geezer with the burger vans packing up. It seems like everyone's going. We'll stick around for a little bit. Just for now, I want one of those hats. With built-in towel. Dodgy towel as well. It's got all oil stains on it and everything. Never cleaned from the day that I got the... from the Vulcan. This is Vulcan oil on this towel, ladies and gentlemen, and it's got a bit of a pong on it as well. We'll be back later, not today, but later, tomorrow, with another show. Just wearing this especially for today, by the way, folks. Storm's on the way, Martin Smith's saying. Jerry, I think you need someone to teach you how to wear a turban. Alan B saying, Rab H. Good afternoon, everybody. If you're just joining us, we are kind of done. We would hear the whistle of those jets as they, even if they're over there. Are you off, mate?
Yep.
Thank you, sir. Look after yourself. See you next time, yeah?
Yeah.
Don't know what we're going to be doing next, but we'll see. Thank you, sir. Take care. A member right there. He was there this morning. Give us a wave, mate. There we go. Oh, there's some people over there as well. Hey! Yes. So, listen, folks, we will be back with more action on Thunder Week on Big Jet TV, even though it's called Afterburner Week. We will keep you updated. Make sure you download the app. Very, very important, folks. I'm not pushing it, because there's no in-store purchases or anything silly like that. It's purely so that you, the avid aviation fan, av geek, whatever you might be, never misses a show, because the great thing is you can carry it in your pocket. You don't have to rely on YouTube to give you your notifications or Facebook. The app is a one-stop shop for your notifications of what we're doing, and it's in the media as well. It's instant bing, whatever it is, the little noise that you get. But anyway, we'll see you on the next show, folks, tomorrow, before I burn me neck off. Take it easy. See you later. Thanks for tuning in, by the way. And thanks for your patience as well. But we got that you too. How about that? See you later. Bye. Horseman asking for the email. info@bigjet.tv. I bet you we turn off and that bleeding Hercules comes out. It's just flipping typical, isn't it? Oh, did we?
Yeah.
How are you doing?
Oh, right, my daughter was an agriculture
there, and there is a reason why I'm holding on. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, brilliant, man. What, did you get the same one?
No, that's how I was over there, but she's sitting on
top of it. Oh, right, yeah, the Peugeot. Nice, nice. Yeah, no, that's cool. I got the auto. It's the only reason why I got the Transit, because it's the only commercial auto. Yeah, yeah.
Yours is more like a car though, isn't it? Yeah, yeah, this thing's like a car, man, honestly. You know. Yeah, fabricated it myself, apart from the actual rack itself. You know, that's a pretty standard, standard.
J-Mo. Yeah, see you later, mate. We'll do something, man. Next week we'll do that show, yeah?